This video is about an Arduino thunder and lightning effect. The program, as I show it here, is fully automated with an additional timing function that enhances your display. I will review the control circuitry later in the video after I explain the visual end of this thing. I will stop talking for a bit so you can see and hear what goes on. As a side note, I have two other thunder and lightning programs. A video of each will be posted later. What I am showing here is three LED light strips on my workbench viewed top down. So you can see better the workings of the LED strips, I chose this view as compared to one with the LEDs in the overhead of the diorama. I will show it operating in a diorama view in another video, which also will show each of the three thunder and lightning effects that I have. The LEDs respond to the sound level of the thunder that is recorded and played on a DFPlayer Pro MP3 player. When the sound of thunder exceeds a given threshold level, the lights flash randomly. That is the basic operation. By the way, codes, materials, lists, and much more are below. I added some features that I think improve the visual effect and eliminate the noise that can become obnoxious if the program is allowed to run constantly. And that occurs very quickly when I have a few dioramas on display with each running thunder. So now let's look at how I control this thing. What we see here is my wiring diagram for the control panel. I have a DFPlayer, which has a thunderstorm recorded on it. That's controlled by another program that makes it start immediately once it's powered up. I have three 12-volt LED strips, which you've seen flashing. They are controlled through some MOSFETs. I have a fourth MOSFET, which is used to control the 5-volt part of the circuitry. I have a switch and a timer. I have a switch to turn this lightning effect on and off. I just don't want it running all the time. So if I want to display it, I turn it on. If I don't, I turn it off. Once I turn it on, I have another switch, a timer. What this does is it runs the flashes and the sound for so many minutes, turns it off for so many minutes, turns it back on, turns it off, and I control the minutes here and there. So it's a very convenient timer. This timer controls this 5-volt MOSFET, which turns the DFPlayer on and off. DFPlayer, the output from the DFPlayer, goes over to a flash controller. This is nothing more than blink circuitry. It blinks randomly. It randomly turns each of these MOSFETs on and off, so the LEDs blink randomly. Now over here with the DFPlayer, again, I have a switch. I may want to just see the light and not have the noise. It can be obnoxious when it's playing. If I have it on display with people around or whatever, they may not want to listen to noise all the time. Plus, I have four dioramas with four different lightning effects in there, each one with its own speaker. Ah, what a noise. So I turn the speaker off with this switch. Rather complex. You can cut back on it. We can eliminate this. I'll show this in another video once I get some work done on the DFPlayer so it works a little better. I need tech support. I'm waiting for that. So this is it. I hope you understand it. If you have questions, call me, comment, or write me. I'm here to help. And if you have any suggestions, leave them in the comments. Thank you for watching.